Welcome back to Fundamentals of Conflict Resolution and Peacebuilding. We started to talk about storytelling in conflict resolution and peacebuilding, and you saw a powerful documentary film which showed you spread the stories of these human beings, very powerful. I want to mention before I talk about the importance of human-to-human encounter, my African students who, I forgot to mention Uganda, Mike Bergeson was one of my graduate students years ago, and he is currently working for the African Union. I believe he and other students are part of the reason, if you saw the African delegation that went to the Russian leader, dictator, Putin, and suggested mediation to build peace in the midst of the war between Russia and Ukraine, you saw the enthusiasm of Africans for mediation. And let me introduce mediation. Hopefully you've read about it in Negotiation Alchemy already, so you've got a bit of an intro. But just in case, mediation is where a trained conflict resolver, peace builder, and I will be talking about their ethical standard of impartiality in another lecture, but they will facilitate parties coming together to negotiate their conflict and hopefully, ideally, to build peace with each other. And after creating a safe space where multicultural parameters, ground rules are negotiated by all parties, for example, you know, no interruption, that's very popular Californian ground rule. It's not practiced by the world, so you can't assume the world is California, but in California, I would say most of the citizens believe that you should not interrupt each other when you're speaking. Even if you have someone who talks and talks and talks in the classroom. So I've had to negotiate other ground rules in the classroom to balance power and make sure everyone gets an opportunity to speak. But anyways, you create a safe space where everybody feels comfortable sharing their story. And this is why you're being introduced to all these skills and values, ethics. It's not easy to do. You build trust. And then the next stage of mediation is storytelling. Everyone has a chance to tell their story as they are comfortable telling their story. And one of your options is this, in this class, is to examine your life narrative, your life story, and decide what you're comfortable sharing with me and your classmates. Very powerful community, storytelling community that has been happening in my classes for the last decade or so. And my students love it. So you'll get an experience. But why is this so critically important? There's a number of reasons. I have a PowerPoint slide here talking about humanizing the dehumanized and the oppressed, the transformative power of human encounter. Paulo Freire, who was a very famous, many of you have read his Pedagogy of the Oppressed, and if you haven't, I recommend you do. He was a very renowned Brazilian educator who believed in educating the poor. If you've ever been to Brazil, you will see the extreme distance between the very wealthy and the poor. And it's horrible, and it contributes to horrific violence. And so he was quite radical, because in Brazil, I'll tell you, if you fight on behalf of the environment, you risk death. It's very radical. You take on the wealthy, powerful elements. And that's what he did, was saying the poor need to be educated. And he said that the poor are responsible for meeting with their oppressors to transform their consciousness by introducing themselves as the human beings that they are. And this sounds very, you know, this is the fearless, courageous storytelling that is promoted at Dominguez. But we don't see it a lot because, yeah, it takes enormous empowerment and courage to do it. But why is this such an important, you know, Martin Buber was the theologian and the philosopher that talked about the need for an I-thou encounter, not an I-it encounter, right? He was a Jewish theologian speaking during the Holocaust, during World War II. And what happens if we don't meet each other human to human is we become objectified, we become labels, we're dehumanized by people who don't know us. So there's all sorts of lies that can go on. And then compound that with what normally happens when there's nasty tit-for-tat crisis and pressure, where everybody gets triggered in their fight response, and we see the worst of each other. We don't see the whole human being. We don't see the whole story. And that's why it's critical to have a storytelling stage, a safe space where people are encouraged to be themselves with each other. What happens, and I hope it will happen in this class, is you are so inspired by each other's humanity, shared struggle, resilience, success, all of it. And you discover that you share more as human beings than you ever imagined. So this is a very important part of what you're studying with conflict resolution and peace building. Now, I introduced last week, many ancient cultures have mediation as part of their practice, but it's very normally patriarchal. You know, it's the elder males of a tribe or a group or community who dictate what everyone else needs to do. That is not what you're studying here. That's what Hofstede referred to as the masculine culture. We are fully embracing the best of the feminine peace building in this class. Good luck and enjoy.